And Jezebel, she got her in. What was Elijah? Elijah was reformation. Restoring, returning, coming back to God, being restored, the fire of God. So Elijah done all this stuff.
Yeah.
And after doing all this stuff, one day he's out there, and he's going along, and he needed another servant. God had ordained Elisha. And Elisha, you know, Elisha's just doing his business. Living his life. I mean, he was probably a praying man. He was probably a man that believed God, sought God, wanted to will God for his life, but he just lived his life. And he's out there, come here, brother. He's out here, and he's got his mules over there. And he's just a plow. Yeah, you plow. He's just a plow, going along. You know all that Elisha was expecting that day? But I'm going to get me a good crop for this year. I'm going to make me some good money off of this. And this old Elijah prophet happened to be walking by, caught up in the Holy Ghost. He done put Jezebel down. Revival had done broke out in Israel. He's walking by and he just stops. And he looks at Elijah and he just said, and puts it back over and walks on.
Come on now.
But Elijah, he tries to go ahead. That was strange. That was something strange about it. But he goes ahead and tries to plow. But now, see, something done happening.
Yeah.
He's shaking behind the plow. What was it? In that man's jacket, that man's coat. I'm just trembling all over. He said, he finally stopped and let them reins go. And he run up and took to catch Elijah. And he said, hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. He said, I'm going to follow you. He said, but something I've seen in this. Now, Elijah, you know, he knew what he was doing.
Yeah.
So Elijah comes around and said, just let me go back home. I'm going to have a goodbye party.
Come on,
I'm going to kill the oxen. I'm going to sacrifice. Let me go back home.
Uh-huh.
What was Elijah's reply to Elisha? What have I to do with you?
Yeah.
I didn't do anything to you. Go home. Go read it. He told him to go home.
That's what he said to him.
How Jesus said, when they came to him and said, Thomas said, let me first go bury my father. Let me go. And Jesus said, let the dead bury the dead. You come follow me. What was God's reply to Elisha? If that's what you want. If that is what you want, go home. But you can't follow me and hold on to that life. You can't follow me and go in the way I'm trying to take you and holding hands with the world. You're going to turn loose on one of them. He told Elisha, go home. Elisha went home, just like he said. Killed his oxen, rather. One of them gave the rest of them to the family. The whole time he was there, I believe Elisha was in a decision. He might have been thinking, oh, God, but what about my crops? I know what I'm feeling. But I just put a good seed out. I've got a good house. I've got all these things. What about all this stuff? But the whole time he's at home, his family's having a party and patting good old Elisha. And they just go on, but Elisha can't hear him. All he can hear is the wind from that jacket just hitting him, something in him shaking and trembling. Something that changed in him. And he said, I tried to live and tried to go on and do that, but he couldn't do it. He said, here, y'all have the oxen. You can have the ground. You can have the crops. And he come with.
Gotta go.
And he come back to Elijah. And he said, as the Lord liveth where I went, where he go, I go, I'll go.
Yeah.
Where are you at? I'm going to be. And he followed him around and he watched. See, what was it? There was something not in the jacket or the man. It was that power that transformed him. It changed him. But that wasn't enough. Oh, that wasn't enough. He followed him around for days and days and followed him around for years probably and serving him. But the day came. Elijah had done all he was going to do in his physical body. And they came to one place. God, Elijah knew it was time for him to go in the physical. And he told Elisha, he said, Elisha, I pray thee, stay here.
Uh-huh.
Elisha's reply was, as the Lord God liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. They went from there to another place and to another place. And he would always say the same thing. You stay here. I got to go here. As the Lord liveth and thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee.
Come on.
Amen.
Come to Bethel.
Yeah.
You stay here in Bethel, Elisha. The Lord has called me to go over Jordan.
Uh-huh.
You stay here.
Yeah.
He said, has the Lord liveth? Has thy soul liveth? I'll not leave thee. Do you know what the Bible said? Said that the sons of the prophets, they watched from afar all this. You know what that meant? Oh, they were religious, Brother Steve. They went and they sung Amazing Grace, How Sweet This Town. They went they but when it came to fall over children, the sons of the prophets, they stayed and watched from afar. They weren't willing to go over Jordan. See, Elijah knew something was fixing to happen on the other side of Jordan, and he wanted to be in on it.
Yeah.
He wanted to get what God was about to do, and just being religious wasn't good enough. He had to go over Jordan. You can either be Elisha, or you can be the sons of the prophet that watched this from afar.
Right.
Elisha said, I'm not leaving thee.
Uh-huh.
In everybody's terms, if I got to handcuff myself to you, Elijah, I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm not leaving you because something is about to happen.
Yeah.
All that you've got to be willing to go over Jordan. Make up your mind that you're going to, see, you got to get your mind made up. I'm crossing Jordan. Jordan is death to your flesh, death to your will, and what you have. It's death to the self life.
Hallelujah.
A lot of folks are serving so far, but when it comes to self denial and taking up the cross, that's too far. How are we going into something greater? And Elisha said, I'll not stay here. And they came to Jordan. And Elisha smote the waters. And Jordan stood up on both sides. And Elijah, I mean, you better stay with this thing. Because not only did Elijah go across, but Elisha walked through Jordan with Elijah. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to walk into this thing. I'm ready to go in and possess this move.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Jesus, where you go, I'll go.
Oh, yes.
Why are you leaving this church in this hour? I'm going to follow you. When Elijah went in, so did Elisha. He got over there, and the sons of the prophets still watching from afar. And they talk a little bit. And Elijah says, I'm going to be taken away from you today. He said, but ask me anything, and I'll give it to you. You'll have it. Lord, Elijah could have asked for anything. I want a new house. I want a new car. I want a bank account. He could have asked anything, and Elijah would have decreed it and been so. But Elijah had more sense than that. And he said, I want a double portion of thy spirit. Woo! So that's when God's doing it. And he said, oh, Elisha, thou askest the hard thing. But if you will see me when I go up, you'll have it. And while they're talking, the Bible said that the horses and chariot of fire comes down and it separates the two of them. And Elisha cries, my father, my father. And when he looks up, hallelujah. The man, he falls in the hands of Elisha, and he's standing there trembling, holding back, and the sons of the prophet still fall off looking. Hallelujah, look at that old crazy Elisha.
Yes.
Oh, what does he think he is? What does he think he's got? Look at him. But Elisha, take it in your hand, brother. And Elisha walks up to Jordan, and he screams out and he says, where is the Lord God? And Elisha. And he smote the waters. He smote the waters.
Yes.
And the waters said,
yeah.
And the sons of the prophet said this, surely the spirit of Elijah doth rest upon Elisha. Not another spirit.
Come on.
The same spirit.
Yes.
It was the spirit of Elijah. But it rested on Elisha. Not a new Holy Ghost, but a greater move of God's power. We don't try to deceive people with trickery of words. Ain't nobody ever said another Holy Ghost, but it's the same. He said, the spirit of Elijah. Not another spirit. Not an Elisha spirit. But Elijah.
Yeah.
Take the rest of prophet Elijah. And Elisha went and done twice the miracles, had the greater of the ministry, same spirit of Elijah, but in a double portion of power. He was so full of it. See, son, you tell you something, son, to the prophet, you better watch the stuff you're putting on Facebook. You better watch the stuff coming out your mouth. Your words, the Bible said, you'll be snared by the words of your mouth. Well, let me tell you, the sons of the prophet, even though they knew God was with Elisha, still went around and talked to their children. Oh, look, they were bald head, the prophet trying to be Elisha when their kids heard him and went out there and began to follow their little bald headed prophet around. See, a double portion rested upon Elijah. And they began to sing and laugh and mock, and they began to say the very same things mom and daddy was saying. Go up, my head. Go up. You think you're Elijah? Go up. Elisha turned around, the Bible said, and called two she bears out of the woods and ate them up alive. You better watch what words you put that for she out your mouth in this move. But watch where you let your tongue take you. Because we're not in little old times no more where you can say anything and just get by with it. Oh, well. See, in this world, God's taking us, every word you speak, everything, God's going to take you into account of it. I mean, I don't know what else is to tell you, preach, but man, Elisha, he had the double portion. He multiplied the level and filled the vessels. I mean, she didn't have none.
No.
Her husband was a real prophet and he died and left dead, so he's going to come and take her kids. Is what you got in the road. Oh, I just got a little bit of oil. You know, that's all I got, just a little oil. They said, go borrow the vessels from your friends and neighbors. Don't buy a little, buy a lot. They filled the house, the bathroom, the hallway, the bedrooms, the front room, the kitchen. Everyone in the house was full of pots. And that double portion took that much oil and began to fill pots until they were all full. And he said, sir, and pay off your debts and live on the rest of it. He raised the dead just like Elijah. And he died. I didn't take all the credit for this. This is Brother Allen's too. The boy that just stood out to me, the spirit of Elijah, same spirit, not a different one, same one.
Yes, Lord.
And his old poor Elijah finally died, and they buried him in an old grave. And he'd been dead for so long that he turned to dust, his bones is all that was left. I don't know how many years it was passed, but it was enough for him to be bones. And a war had broke out, and a fleeing army had been coming through the land. Come here, Elisha. Come here, lay over here. You're in the cave dead. You ain't nothing but bones. Right there on those steps, lay there. Hallelujah. And they're in war. They're fighting, you know, and they're fleeing from an army. They ain't got time. One of their guys gets wounded. Come here, brother. And he's wounded, and he's leaning on him. He says, oh, I don't think I can make it. And all of a sudden, he dies.
Come on now.
And they take him. So we ain't got time for a proper burial. We just got to get rid of him. And the Bible said they threw him into the cave. And the minute he touched